Now, when I talk about, agile development methodology, I would like to just sum up, the topic today is quality practices in agile and not in going in details of agile development as such. I'm assuming that people are aware of agile development methodology, but I would like to bring everybody on the same page again in this webinar by spending a couple of minutes on what is the focus on agile development. So typically agile, I generally call it as a philosophy. It's a leadership philosophy. In this philosophy, not you and me are important, but we, us, it's us, the team. There's a close collaboration between the team members. It's a safe, organized, disciplined team. Everybody is accountable for their own task and responsibilities. The team is empowered, and there's full control on decision making. Now this team has to work hand in hand together to deliver, and that is the crux of agile. Okay, and then the focus is we develop small incremental releases which are shippable, which are value adding from customer perspective. Okay, now because the focus is just on limited functionality and limited user stories per sprint, it can be better evaluated, and because of the frequent inspections and adaptation, it is easy for us to deploy the quality. And now what is important in this agile is the user involvement, the customer involvement, which is
Hi Rama, there is a slight audio problem from your end. Can you please check? We are just checking with the speaker. Please have patience. Rama has some audio problems. Please be online. She would join back soon. Hello, Rama. Can
Hello.
you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Aradhana, I'm extremely sorry. I know GoToMeeting just lost its connection.
It's all right. We are still online, so I'm making you the presenter, and you can start the
Yeah.
webinar where we have left off.
Yeah, sure, definitely.
Rama, I just give you the presenter rights. Have you received it?
Yes, I have received this. Yeah. Okay, can you see my screen?
Yes, it's viewable. Can you go to the slideshow mode?
Yeah, I'll just. Yeah. So I'll start from here again. Yeah. Extremely sorry, guys. My GoToMeeting's connectivity was lost for a couple of minutes. So we are back again.
All right, Rama,
okay,
you can continue.
Yeah, fine. Yes. So, you know, agile development methodology is a unique development methodology which has its unique mess. You know, it categorizes like individual personal interaction more over processes and tools. You know, it prefers working software over documents, customer collaboration over contract negotiation, responding to changes over following a plan, and daily build creation. Now, these are some of the practices which are used in Agile. You may see this in Agile Alliance, very commonly used, these terminologies. So, the whole methodology talks about responding to changes, being agile, you know. So, daily build creation, preferably automated using continuous integration tools, you know, and then daily testing, daily defect detections, identifying issues as early as possible, then explicitly specify acceptance criteria for user stories, preferably automated testing for regression, you know, and better focus on the sprints and planning sprints with some capacity, you know, like tests we have, and based on the man hours, we relate them to the story points. So we have predictable deliverables and predictable velocity. Velocity is how many story points our team has delivered in this particular capacity, number of man hours, you know. Now, when we talk about agile, you know, whatever the focus which I say, what is needed in the software development, that you develop iteratively because the focus is better. You manage requirements and changes because we are agile and we have, you know, a better collaboration with all the stakeholders. All these things, they are implemented automatically, naturally. So when we talk about develop iteratively, we say that, you know, we have objective milestones defined for those different sprints. We identify critical risks as soon as possible. We collaboration, you know, like typically collaboration drives the solutions and get user feedback as soon as possible. And as I said, you know, managing requirements in Agile is the only one thing which I say very differently done in Agile than in other development methodologies. Because requirements evolve by collaboration. Understanding requirements from customers, from business analysts and all the stakeholders, you know, implementing the change control within the sprint. Now, change requests are prioritized, their impact is assessed. If impact is sizably big and our schedule is going haywire in the sprint, then we can take this story in the next sprint. Okay? But then, depending on the sprint status and impact of those change requests, we can make a decision whether we want to implement this particular story with the change request in the current sprint or we would like to go ahead and deploy it in the next sprint. Okay? And then what about architecture, you know? The component-based architecture is the focus of today's software, where we use different components because we want, you know, to divide the whole product into different small chunks, and we should focus on the reusability of these components. This leads to improved maintainability and extensibility. This also helps us to promote clean division of work assignment. You know, we can, based on the modules, based on the different interfaces, how these modules are linked, what will be the sequence of the module development, how interfaces should be linked together to ensure that the components are built together, we delegate these different component-based assignments to our team members. Then we come to working software. So working software is the main crux of Agile. Now, visual modeling, which improves our, you know, we improves our understanding of the requirements along with, you know, managing the software complexity. This also helps us to capture the structure and behavior of the components and promotes unambiguous communication between the team. Okay. Another thing is Agile focuses also on the qualities, some of the quality practices like pair programming, peer code review. In many organizations, one story is owned by a developer and a QA, a testing member, you know. Then we have continuous integration, continuous testing. These are practices which are adopted in Agile. Then we have acceptance criteria for each story. And then we measure product success more than measuring process success, you know. So what is important again is a working software. The ready executable code on the machine is more important than any other thing. So the crux of the Agile is collaboration, empowered team. All issues are owned by the team to drive solutions. There is a complete transparency and no surprises at the end.